happened tonight for us?
We were walking down the street and saw your sign and thought it was very interesting. And my friend, who is basically an atheist, thought that it would be interesting to talk to you about your sign. And I'm really glad that he did, because as you said, as Larry said, we've been talking for over an hour. And it's been really, really, really good for me, and I think really good for Thomas as well. And it's really opened my eyes to a lot of different things that I already knew about, but Larry really brought to the forefront about really showing God your faith through acting and doing what you can for God. Because it's like you said, if you're walking down the street and see someone sleeping and their house is on fire, you have to tell them. That's what Larry's doing. And I don't know.
Oh, cool, man. I tell you, have you changed your positions on anything since we talked, or have you learned anything that you might want to apply in your life?
Well, I guess repenting of sins is one, like with that girl that I talked about. With the relationships I've had with people in the past where I've wronged them, I need to repent of things like that and maybe have a conversation with him about it. And it's not really based on what their response is. It's based more on the fact that the person I really sinned against was God, and I need to make things right with God by attempting to make things right with the person and repenting and showing, yeah, setting an example for them too.
What do you think you can do to help yourself resist temptation, you know, and help yourself walk in a closer relationship with God? What do you think you can do?
To draw closer to God and to focus every day more on God and surround myself more with godly-minded people. And repent and keep God in mind all the time.
So what are you going to do after we end our talk? Are you going to hang out here? Are you going to leave? What are you going to do?
I'll probably try to leave and drive Thomas away. I don't know if we really will, because right now he's trying to hook up with a bunch of crazy people. But I'll do my best to pack him away. Because I look like a bunch of jerks anyway.
Well, cool, man. Yeah, I tell you what, it's really a pleasure to meet you. You know, you seem like you have a hunger for the Lord. I think you're right, you know, going in the right direction, but I don't think you have anyone to actually work with you or help you to draw closer, like to go out with you and to help you do something for God. I mean, who can you go to? I mean, do you go to church? Do you have a church, or is it a dead church, or what?
No, the church that I attend is on the internet. My dad goes to it. It actually reminds me a lot of you guys with Full Contact Christianity. It's really cool. I don't always attend it as often as I'd like, and I feel bad about that. And I do want to go to it more. Other than that, I really don't have a church that I go to.
That's probably why you still love God.
Yeah, that's a very good point. A lot of pulpits today are dead and really, really just tickle people's ears and don't spread the words that would move people to take action. And just like that one guy who walked by and said, "Oh, I go to church every Sunday." Well, good for you. What do you know? It's a sad situation in America. But,
so what's with the beats, John? Are you
going
to be conformed to the world or transformed?
What?
Are you going to be conformed to the world, or are you going to be transformed by the renewing of your mind?
I want to be transformed.
Okay. Well, you got to get rid of those beasts. You got to get rid of them, man. They represent wickedness and perversion. You're taking part of a wicked event right now. If I were to look at you, I wouldn't be able to tell if you were a Christian or a sinner.
I was supposed to trust you if your sign's upside down. Your life's upside down.
So I ask you, John, do you love God more than you love your beats?
Yeah, I do.
Are you going to make a statement for my YouTube guys? Are you going to take them off? Are you going to throw them down? Can you get rid of that garbage?
Hey, look what was underneath.
Hey, there you go.
I guess I almost forgot for a second.
Hey, throw them in that garbage. Yeah, there you go. There they are. Good job. There you go. Good job, John. See, now that's... That's, there you go. He's throwing his drink down too.
All right.
Praise the Lord, man. See, now that's the right thing to do. See, you make the right decision. Life is about making right choices. Now you start with right choices. You build on those with right choices. Yeah. You build your life on making right choices, and on those right choices, make other right choices, and that's how you become successful.
It's exactly what you said a while ago. He told me, you might walk 10 miles into a dark forest, well, you gotta walk 10 miles out. That made a lot of sense to me. I've done a lot of bad things in my life, and I've tried to make them right, but I haven't walked the whole 10 miles out yet, you know? But I guess, like you said,
at least you're pointed in the right direction, huh?
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, praise the Lord, man. God bless you.
Yeah. Praise the Lord.